This Mass is offered as a thanksgiving for the favors received by John Alexis family and Patty Milton Peters family and AX Alexander family, AJ Loyola family, and Dr. Naveen Alexander, who celebrates his birthday today. And for the favors received by Jean Johnson's family, Sudarshan Selvakumar, Axelia Monica, for their newly married life. Let's also thank the Lord for all the favors received from Him. Let's pray for the special intentions of Judith Louise for good health, L.S. Roy for good health, Eric Augustine Edmonds for special intentions. Let's also pray for the repose of the souls of Thomas Royan, Alexander Joseph Saldana, Meena Roy, and deceased members of Soane's family, Mary and Eric and Sheila Edmonds, Harry Vasant, and James Manasseh. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Once a man wanted to get rid of his shadow, and he was running in all directions possible, but of no use. And a wise man suggested, if you want to get rid of your own shadow, you should go and stand beneath the shadow of a tree. My dear friends, all of us would like to get rid of sorrow, get rid of the cross from our lives. Saint Louis de Montfort used to say, no cross, what a cross. My dear friends, cross is the yoke that connects each one of us to Christ. We cannot have a cross without Christ, nor a Christ without a cross. We are followers of Christ because we too carry our own burdens, crosses, along with the cross of Christ. In this Mass, let us pray that God may give us necessary strength to carry the cross, to carry our life's burdens. At times, we have tried to escape from the cross, to get rid of the cross. Let us feel sorry and ask the Lord pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 20, verse 7 to 9. The word of the Lord has become for me a reproach. O Lord, thou hast deceived me, and I was deceived. Thou art stronger than I, and thou hast prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all the day. Everyone mocks me. For whenever I speak, I cry out, I shout, violence and destruction. For the word of the Lord has become for me a reproach and a derision all day long. If I say, I will not mention him or speak any more in his name, there is in my heart, as it were, a burning fire shut up in my bones, and I am weary with holding it in, and I cannot. This is the word of the Lord. Your response to the psalm, for you my soul is thirsting, O Lord my God.
For you my soul is thirsting, O Lord my God.
O God, you are my God, for you I long. For you my soul is thirsting. My body pines for you like a dry, weary land without water. Your response, for you my soul is thirsting, O Lord my God. So I gaze on you in the sanctuary to see your strength and your glory. For your love is better than life. My lips will speak your praise. Response, for you my soul is thirsting, O Lord my God. So I will bless you all my life. In your name I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled as with a banquet. My mouth shall praise you with joy. Your response,
for you my soul is thirsting, O Lord my God.
For you have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice. My soul clings to you. Your right hand holds me fast. Response,
for you my soul is thirsting, O Lord my God.
The second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. I appeal to you, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may prove what is the will of God, what is good, acceptable, and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel acclamation.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia.
Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia to the Lord.
I am the living bread which came down from heaven, says the Lord. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 16, verses 21 to 27. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and the chief priests and scribes, and be killed, on the third day be raised. And Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, God forbid, Lord, this shall never happen to you. But Jesus returned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are a hindrance to me, for you are not on the side of God, but of men. Then Jesus told his disciples, if any man would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and forfeits his life? Or what shall a man give in return for his life? For the Son of Man is to come with his angels, the glory of his Father, and then he will repay every man for what he has done. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
A religious sister in the catechism class was explaining the stations of the cross for the children. She was explaining first, second, and third. She came to the fourth station, where Jesus on the road to Calvary meets his mother. She explained that even though they could not talk to each other, mother and son spoke just using their eyes. Sister asked the children, what do you think they said to each other? The class gave many different answers. A sickly little girl raised her hand, got up and said, sister, I know what the Blessed Mother told Jesus. She told him, keep on going, Jesus. My dear friends, Mother Mary understood the Christian principle of no suffering, no salvation. No cross, no crown. No pain, no gain. Last Sunday, we read of Simon Peter confessing Jesus to be the Messiah, the Son of the Living God. That profession of faith gained him the name Peter, the rock, a strong one. That particular incident was a high point in the development of the mission of Jesus. Then we know what had happened. Matthew, the Gospel, chapter 16, verse 21 says, from that time on, from the confession of St. Peter as Jesus as the Messiah, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and undergo great suffering at the hands of the elders, and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, on the third day be raised. Popular Jewish belief at the time of Jesus expected a Messiah who would bring instant glory to Israel in terms of military success, wealth and prosperity. The disciples also shared this popular Jewish belief. So when Peter heard Jesus announcing that he must first endure the cross, Peter must have guessed that Jesus must have made a mistake. So he took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him, saying, "God forbid, Lord, this must never happen to you." Peter was asking Jesus to abandon the narrow, the hard way of the Messiah. Although Jesus had called Peter as a rock, he now looks at Peter and says to him, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block." The rock has become the stumbling block to Jesus. My dear friends, the gospel of Christ is a coin with two sides, the cross and the crown. If we try to embrace one side, the glorious side, and reject the other side, the suffering side, we falsify the gospel. The same Jesus who said, "Come to me, all that you are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest," also said, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up the cross and follow me." Do we come to Jesus to be freed from our meaningless and futile burdens, or do we come to Jesus to take up the cross that leads to salvation and glory? There was a lady who spent her time working for the Lord, visiting the sick, helping the elderly, and so on. And she was diagnosed of a knee problem which needed surgery. The surgery was unfortunately not a success, and so it left her in a constant pain and unable to walk. It seemed that the Lord had ignored her prayers and the prayers of her friends for a successful surgery. This was a woman who considered herself as a personal friend of Jesus. She was utterly disappointed. One day she shared this, her experience, her pain, with the parish priest. And the priest suggested that she go into prayer and ask her friend Jesus why he treated her in this way. And she did. The next day, the priest met her and saw peace all over her face in spite of her knee pain. She said, "Father, as I was looking at the crucified Jesus and telling him about my bad knee, he said to me, 'Mine is worse.'" My dear friends, it did not all go well with Jesus. He still had to endure the cross, carry the cross. It did not all go well with Mary. A sword of sorrow still pierced her heart. It did not all go well with the countless men and women, saints, who have gone before us. Why then it should all go well with you and me? The face of disappointment, sickness, ingratitude, failure, our faith response should be not to question, "Why me?" but to recognize that these crosses and contradictions, these pains and struggles, are the necessary condition for our future glory. The world is the place of the cross. The place of the crown is heaven. Amen. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the one begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, our Heavenly Father loves us so much that he sent his only Son as our Redeemer. And Jesus loves each one of us so much that he was ready to sacrifice and ready to carry the cross. Following Jesus, let us ask the Lord the grace to follow him with our own crosses.
Your response will be, Lord, help us to be patient in suffering.
Lord, help us to be patient in suffering.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that they may carry out the prophetic role to which they are called by correcting those who do wrong and encouraging those who do right. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be patient in suffering.
That Christians may accept the hardships that come in the living of their faith for Jesus, himself has been subjected to severe suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be patient in suffering.
That no innocent person may be falsely accused and made to suffer for things they have not said or done. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be patient in suffering.
That Christians may have the freedom of worship and freedom to practice their faith, even if they are living in an environment that is predominantly non-Christian. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be patient in suffering.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that enlightened by the Word of God, we may accept the hardships and trials that come our way because Jesus himself has suffered and died to save us from sin and death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be patient in suffering.
Please pray for your personal and community needs.
Let's pray for the end of the pandemic. Let's pray for all those who are taking treatment in the hospitals. Let's pray that God may give them strength to overcome this pandemic. Let's pray for all the health officials who take care of the patients. Let's pray for the wisdom for our rulers to find immediate solution to this pandemic. Let's pray for ourselves that we may not be selfish, rather that we show our care and concern to the people affected. O God, our refuge and our strength, hear our prayers and grant, we pray, that what we ask in faith we may truly obtain. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
In the sacred mystery, we Eucharistic feast we all appraise. In your light and in your sight we celebrate this holy rite. As these gifts we offer now become a light. This host of wheat, this cup of wine, and all our lives become divine. All these gifts we offer now become a light.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always a blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
until you come, until you come again, until you come, until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and George our Bishop and all the clergy, the religious and the faithful. Let us remember and pray for all the sick and the suffering. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence to our Heavenly Father for all our needs. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Jesus, Lamb of God, see Jesus bearer of our sins. Take our sins, Lord, take our sins, Lord, give us mercy, Lamb of God.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy. Jesus,
behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let's continue to pray for God's mercy in the whole world.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, O Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve in our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son.
And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us.